Welcome back to Proactive. I'm joined on the line now by James Gilbertson, the VP of Exploration at Amaroq Minerals, who's going to be talking to us a little bit about some new results from the copper mine license in Greenland. So, James, perhaps you'd like to start by telling us what these results mean.
Certainly, and first of all, thank you for having us back. So, yes, we're just announcing our license results from the copper mine berg license. And the copper mine berg in Danish means copper mine bay. The reason it's got that name is it actually hosts a previously operating copper mine that operated as early as the 1850s through to the early 1900s, where a small amount of high-grade copper was produced. So we picked this license up in 2021, and we've been conducting some exploration over the last 2 years, but specifically this year, and that's what we're announcing now. So it sits on the southwest corner of a tract that we've been exploring and expanding of copper anomalism, running all the way from Sava, which we previously announced, through to copper mine, about a strike length of about 120 kilometers. So these results are they're early stage, and it is perhaps unsurprising that we found some high grade copper in a region that was obviously previously operated. But there's some really important take homes from this that have given us some really encouraging notes and encouraging us to conduct further exploration as we move forward into 2023.
Fantastic. So what do these results tell us about the wider exploration piece?
Certainly. So I think the key take homes for me is that A, we've discovered that the mineralization at Yoshua, which is the old operating mine, continues well beyond the outline of the former mine. And that the attitude of that mineralization seems to be indicative of the mineralization bellowing out at depth and along strike. So that will give us something much more economic in size. So that's really encouraging for the Yoshua area. But what's more important, perhaps, is that we have defined and confirmed that this is a style of mineralization called skarn mineralization. Now, skarns form at the juncture between granites and host rocks. So therefore, you know, we now have a strike length that is potentially prospective for similar style high-grade copper, gold, and silver mineralization over a strike length of about 40 kilometers. And we believe there's actually two of these. So in total, around about 80 kilometers worth of strike now worthy of exploring across the license. And then underlying all of that is that copper mine sits in an expanding region that Amaroq has been exploring, this new sort of copper belt of southern Greenland that extends that 120 kilometers all the way through to Sava and North Sava, our licenses, where we have a lot of anomalous copper in the forms of IOCG styles, skarn styles, and others, which is really giving us a real encouragement for the future as we move our copper exploration forward.
Understood. And you have just mentioned the future there. So what can we expect from Amaroq in the weeks and months to come?
Well, firstly, we continue to conduct our studies on the copper mine results. And we're putting that into conjunction with the results that we picked up and announced previously at Sava. And we have some other results on that belt to announce as well. But going forward into this year at Copper Mine, we're looking to conduct more detailed studies on that skarn mineralization to understand the exact attitude, the style, and the mineralogy of that. And then to expand out by doing a geophysical survey. Now, we've been very successful in the contractor and the style and the type of geophysics that we've been conducting over the last 2 years. We're going to expand that now and employ the same techniques at Copper Mine and look forward to developing those targets further into 2023.
Wonderful. Well, we look forward to some more updates before long, James. But until then, thank you very much for coming to talk to us at Proactive.
Thank you.